canon of taxation, economics language behind taxation purpose. So we had discussed canon of equity, canon of flexibility, right? Canon of productivity, canon of cost benefit, canon of economy that we say, right? Many things we had discussed from an economics angle. So taxes should be there in India or should not be there in India? It should be there in India if you want and expect a developed nation, right? Nation cannot be developed without paying taxes. You know what the beautiful tagline of GST? Nation is made when taxes are paid, right? So what is the reverse language? Nations cannot be made without, if taxes are not paid. So if you want that your nations as a developed nation, please pay taxes, okay? This is what they say. Secondly, sir, taxes cannot be levied. We have discussed Indian hierarchy of law. In Indian hierarchy of law, the supreme law is my Constitution of India. Under Constitution of India, we are having so many acts in India. Under Act, we are having rules to support that Act. And apart from that, we are having bylaws issued by our institutes, right? Under that, we have started our discussion on Constitution of India. I told you one of the article of Constitution of India is Article 265, which says that no taxes can be levied in India except by authority of law. So that means there has to be an act before passing any act, any tax in India. That act can be passed by either central government or state government. Power has been divided on these two government, right? According to Article 245, central government means law will be made in parliament, and state government means law will be made by state legislative assembly. Now your question must be, sir, which government can make which laws? Center is authorized for making what kind of law, and state is authorized for making what kind of law, and can they both come together and pass any law? Yes, for that you should have understanding of Article 246, 7th schedule, which has three lists. List 1, List 2 and List 3. List 1 union list, List 2 state list and List 3 concurrent list. Now concurrent list doesn't have any revenue law. This was MCQ in CMA or CS, I don't remember. That one of the lists doesn't have any revenue tax law, and that is concurrent list. Alright, this question again may come in exam because many people with general understanding, they know that there is a CGST and SGST, right? So what they can feel, array, concurrent means both government together, that means GST is under concurrent list, whereas I told you that concurrent list doesn't have any revenue law, any revenue law. Am I clear? And neither it is written in union list, nor it is written in state list. And that's the origin of Article 246A. Whenever you see A, that means this article was not there originally in Constitution. The article originally that we have is Article 246. They inserted altogether one new whole article in Constitution to bring GST in India, and before that they made one act together to amend my constitution, which is known as Constitution Amendment Act 2016. For GST, they had amended constitution by passing an act, and through that act, one of the article, many article has been inserted in constitution, one of the article is Article 246, which gives power to state government as well as central government. But state government is powerful only if sale is made intrastate. Sale is made intrastate. Whenever sale is made intrastate, two government will come into picture and take taxes, and which is fair now. Why? Because Maharashtra, if you make money in Maharashtra, or if you supply goods in Maharashtra, you are supplying goods in India as well as in Maharashtra. And that's why two government are taking taxes. CGST, AGST. But whenever Maharashtra government sell goods to Gujarat, now there cannot be three GST. Central GST, Maharashtra GST, Gujarat GST. Person will commit suicide here. And that's why central government says, yaar, you both should not charge GST now. This is interstate matter, and that time I should enter in this particular transaction, I'll charge IGST. General understanding. Then specific we will talk later on. So you should understand there are three types of GST, at least as of now. One is CGST, SGST and IGST. And if it is union territory, if you are a union territory, then UTGST, like state. Union territory is small, no? Dadra Nagar Haveli, Chandigarh, right? Div Daman, right? So there are small this union territories we have, which doesn't have state legislative assembly, and on that central government has passed one act, and that is UTGST. So four GST law: CGST, HGST, IGST, and UTGST. Right? So we have to discuss all these laws in detail. Secondly, sir, I missed one entry here while writing about Constitution of India, and that was entry number 51, and which is still there. That even after launching GST, this entry is still there, and that is entry number 51, and that is on state excise. So you can see there are two types of excise duty: central excise and state excise. Okay, and we have central sales tax also and state sales tax. So state sales tax means VAT, and central sales tax means CST. It was on intrastate, and this was on interstate. Old law. Okay, sir. Entry 51, state excise duty on alcoholic liquor for human consumption. So if you are selling goods for manufacturing goods for, here it was sale. Right? Here it is manufacturing. If you are manufacturing alcoholic liquor for human consumption, then who will levy excise duty? I'm saying GST is not applicable. What is applicable? Excise duty. But my question is that who will charge excise duty on alcoholic liquor for human consumption? Can you see it in this list? No, it is there in state list. Sir, but tobacco? Central. So, unhone tambaku rakh liya, inhone daru rakh liya. Aur GST mein kyun nahi laya? Because they don't want to give any benefit of credit on tobacco as well as and drugs. Indian hemp, charas, ganja, opium, Indian hemp, right? Indian hemp is a ganja, I guess, or charas. Hindi words, right? I don't know. Opium, Indian hemp, and other narcotic drugs for human consumption. All right. Now here I am asking: tobacco,
central.
Charas, ganja,
state.
Indian hemp, state. Opium, state. Manufacturing, huh? For human consumption, state. For toiletry preparation or medical preparation, central. Here it is clearly written: alcoholic liquor for human consumption,
state.
Alcoholic liquor for industrial use,
central.
Because we have not given all. See, in central we have alcoholic liquor for industrial purpose and opium, hemp, this is at central level. Central level means under GST now. Okay, because it is not in this list. Okay, so if it is in human consumption, the word is written as?
Human.
Then only state excise duty. You understand only this? GST, we will study in GST. So state excise duty is there or it is abolished? Still there. On what? Alcoholic liquor for? Human consumption, opium, Indian hemp, and other narcotic drugs, again for human consumption. Okay,
yes.
Yeah, please write it down, finish it.